Shall we start? Okay, good afternoon, namaste. Can you hear me? Is my voice clear? Can you hear me? Can I have a seat, raise of hands if you can hear me? Okay, good. So welcome to the session again. Welcome to today's session. Will be interesting. You know, we want to share the market outlook for 2018. So there are certain indicators which we want to share, because the challenge in the market today is that the market has to, we should also know the exit in the market. We know the entry in the market, but the exit sometimes, you know, we should know. And so what can happen in the market? I want to show you some history. You know, this is a very important history which you should know. Okay, so in 2000, due to the dot-com crisis, you know, S&P was 1574. Okay, and it made a low of 771. We lost about 51%. At the same time, Nifty was 1818 and it came down to 1920. We lost 50%. So people don't remember, because many people who do not know about the history, I'm in the stock market since 1992. And I have observed that, you know, we should see the market, that the market can fall by 50% also. So there are certain indicators. I want to share one thing. Keep market falls only when there is a fundamental crisis, or there is a fundamental problem in the macroeconomics of USA. So India is a two and a half trillion economy. The trillion economy. US is a 30 trillion economy. Okay, it is more than 14-15 times bigger. So if a market is 15 times bigger, okay, you have to understand that if anything happens in US, it affects globally every market. And we have seen that Nifty will only fall 50% if US will fall 50%. No other country can make Nifty fall 50% except the US. Okay, so I want to highlight that same thing had happened in 2000, and the same thing again happened in 2007-8. Nifty was S&P 500. I don't know if you know, S&P 500 is the most popular index in the world. I think so. The daily turnover is $150 billion or $200 billion. $200 billion in the futures options. Ka to I'm not even calculating. So the market in 2007, again, because of the housing crisis, there was a fundamental problem. The market went from 1587 to 665, again a fall of 50%, and Nifty from 6357 came down to 2540. Nifty also fell by 60%. Okay, why we are discussing this? Because there are certain indicators which are showing, I'll just show you the chart also. There are certain indicators which is showing that the same thing might happen in 2018. Okay, 2018, we can see the same thing. So today the buy and hold strategy is not very good. Okay, you have to change your strategy. It has to be a buy and a fast exit strategy. You have to book your profits very early. You cannot have a very buy and hold strategy in 2018. You start your buy and hold strategy from 2019. This is my view. Okay. Now, what has happened in US? Why the market may fall, US market may fall by 50%, and why India Nifty can go down to 6,000? What are the 3-4 indicators? Okay. The number one thing you have to understand, the market only falls when there is a macroeconomic problem. What is macroeconomics? Jab koi country mein koi major problem hota hai. So jab ye this problem had happened in 2007-8, that time there was a big fiscal deficit. there was a fiscal deficit in the market. Fiscal deficit hota hai country ka jo, it had reached 9%. Okay. Abhi Trump ne kya kiya December mein, there is, has been a tax cut from 39% to 21%. So we are expecting that the US market will grow. But what happened is after 1 month, after the tax cut, we are realizing, so people are already realizing that the fiscal deficit will grow in a very big way. So if the fiscal deficit will grow, there is some inflationary pressures also, and interest rates will also be continuously raised in the market. Okay. So there are three, four indicators which usually people do not see or do not follow. Okay. These, what are the different indicators I want to show you? One is the bond price. Now, if you see, the bond price is continuously falling. It has made a 6-year low. Okay. So if the bond prices go down, this is a 10 year. The 10 years is supposed to be the most liquid bond in the world in all countries. 10 year bonds. They are supposed to have the highest volume. So if you see the 10 year bond, the 10 year bond has made a 6-year low and the yields are going up. Okay. So when the interest rate goes up, there are very high chances that the interest rate will be raised by the Fed. Okay. But that is not the query. When even the bond prices goes down, that means there is something which the investors don't see US as a, you know, a good country for bond investment for the near future. So there is a fall of a 6 years low bond price. So this is one indicator. This actually bond price started falling from 11 January. It broke this low of 122. Okay. And the market, India market started falling from 15 January. Global market started falling from 15 January. And Nifty, because of the our clearing, it started falling after the clearing ended on 29 January. Nifty also started falling. So there was a huge, you know, market problem due to the bond price. So I really request you, these charts are available. Where did you take? These charts are available in investing.com. Right. So if you go to investing.com, it's a free thing. You are right now logged in through investing.com. So if you go through investing.com, you can see these charts. Okay. So you see the 10-year chart regularly. Okay. If it keeps on going down, there will be further problem in the economy. So that is one indicator which you need to see for the next year. Okay. Another thing is which you have to see, because of the bond price, the 3-month treasury is continuously going up. Right now, the US interest rate is 1.5%. Okay. So basically, the 3-month already in advance shows what is going to be the interest rate. So the next interest rate is on 21st March. 3 months. 21st March is the next Fed interest rate date. So if this goes to 1.75 in the next 7, 8, 10 days, then on 21st March, the interest rate will be again increased. So if the interest rate will keep increasing again, you keep seeing the 3-month treasury. So there is a study by Tim Woods. If you will go to Google Tim Woods and you will see a 3-month treasury, you will see that the Fed only follows the 3-month. So you can predict in advance whether Fed will increase the rates or not. It's a very simple formula. Very few people know. Okay. So whenever the 3-month treasury is at 1.75, so on 21st March, they will increase the rate. You will know in advance. Okay. So if it goes to 1.8, then there will be further pressure. So you have to keep seeing the 3-month treasury in 2018. Okay. Another thing which you need to show is the dollar index chart, which is also showing a lot of weakness. It was 104. It is already, if you see, it is at about 89 right now. Okay, so the dollar becoming continuously weak. So it affects the trade with many countries. Okay, so dollar is also becoming weaker and weaker. So there is a dollar weakness, there is a US rate uncertainty, there is a bond price. So these three things only, if you see regularly in investing.com, you will see that these things are very, very important, which will decide whether the stock market will fall or not. See, the entire world market only sees either currency, bonds and equities. Only three things are supposed to be seen in macroeconomics: bonds and the yields, okay, which goes vice versa. The second is dollar index. The third is the equity market. Now I'll show you some, as I said, we'll show you some interesting parts where we have to start worrying now. Okay, now if you see, the first time the market made a high on 24th March 2000, the first time it fell 15%. And again, there was a sharp fall, right? Now, if you see the current chart of S&P, now if you see, it has already done a sharp fall of 12%. Can you see this? So this is the first indicator, if you see this. So in 2000, there was this first fall. Okay, then the market stabilized. Okay, so for 6 months, the market was unstable, but did not make a new high. So we don't know, the market might again turn bullish. So I will say that you should become bullish in the market only after 11,300 Nifty. Don't become bullish in the market before 11,300. 11,300 ke pehle, don't be bullish in the market. Okay, so and for S&P, don't be bullish in the market unless it goes up more than 2900. So the real bull play will come only if the market goes above 11,300 or 2900. Before that, we have to be slightly very, very cautious. So this was the first fall. Okay, now I'll show you 2008 S&P chart. Okay, so again, there was this fall of 21%. Okay, this was the fall, this was a bigger fall from 22nd January, from about 1500, it went down to 1300. So this was a big fall of about 10-12% here. Okay, so again, the market went into a, for 2-3 months, the market went into a, okay, so same thing is happening right now. The market has made a low of 2530. So if the market breaks this level, now if you see history, when the market broke this, it went down tremendously again. So there was a big fall, the market went down. So till the time it did not break this, we were not worrying. But when it broke this, that was the first condition that the market will further keep going down. So right now we see, right now the market is goes like up, it goes up, right? Right now we may see the market again high, again low, again high, again low, again high, again low. So this might be the condition in the market for 2018. So be very careful. Okay, so if S&P breaks 2515, we are not in a good position in 2018. Okay, that is why we are saying that you, and again, the short term tax is 15%, the long term tax is 10%. So you are not going to lose on taxes, but try to change your strategy right now. Even if you enter at dips and try to book profits. I'm not saying do short term trading, but don't hold more than maybe 20 days, 1 month, 1.5 month, don't hold the shares. It's not a holding period share where the market will keep going up. If you see, the market, it will not be like this right now. Can you see this chart? The market will not be like this in 2018. This is my view. Once the market goes above 11,300 and if it crosses 2900, then we can be bullish again. We can again buy and hold the shares, not before that. Okay, now if you see the Nifty chart, same thing had happened in Nifty. Same thing had happened in Nifty. Only the date's different, but from 1818, it went down to 850. So it fell about 50%. 50% there was a fall in Nifty also. It's a very similar chart in Nifty also. Okay. If you see 2008, same position. So till the time it had not broken this, there was no problem. But the once it broke this, what had fallen, once it broke this level, then again the market went like this. And the market goes, because people think, how can Nifty go to 6,000? The market made a high of 11,700 and 50% is about 6,000. So it is possible that Nifty may go to 6,000. So if the Nifty large cap falls by 50%, the small cap, mid cap falls by more than 80%. So even the company is giving fantastic results, because the macroeconomics is a problem. Even if the company is giving fantastic results, the share prices will keep going down. So if you have some experience of 2001, 2008, I have seen these two markets very, very closely. I have done a lot of trading in these two markets. Okay, so we are telling you in advance that slightly be careful. Don't be in a rush. Okay, the bullish signs are only above 11,300 and 2,900. So be very careful. Keep seeing the US charts on investing.com regularly, the S&P 500. If it breaks 2515 or 2510, okay, we have to be very careful. It is a time to reduce your portfolio slightly from the equity stuff and put more money into maybe some money in gold ETFs. You can put some money in gold ETFs. You can put some money in. So try to shift some money. Or if you cannot manage, make sure you give your money to a fund manager who knows these things, that if he buys and then he exits. So exit strategy is very important in 2008. If you do not have an exit strategy, your DMAT value, if it is 1 crore today, in 1 year's time, the DMAT value might be 20 lakhs. So we feel that we have 1 crore rupees, but if you have not converted that 1 crore into cash, then you still have that share will go to 20 lakhs. So be very careful that I have seen portfolio going down by more than 80% in 1 year, in 2001 and 2008. So this is pure experience, and this will only happen, again I'm repeating, this will only happen if US will break 2515. If US will not break 2515, it is not going to happen. Okay, so this is the chart in, so again if you see, I'm again showing you, S&P was 1574, came down to 771, 51% fall. 2008, 58-60% fall. Okay, so this is very, very important. Take this thing very, very seriously. 2008, same thing. First, the market fell. Again, Nifty, if you see the same chart. Okay, so many people say it is happening in US. Many people do not link the macroeconomics with US. So that is a very, very big mistake. They think US ka problem in India mein kya hoga. मैं आपको 2001 का भी चार्ट दिखा दिया हूं और 2008 का भी चार्ट दिखा दिया. अगर यूएस में कुछ प्रॉब्लम होगा, इंडिया विल बी अफेक्टेड. ओके, सो प्लीज कीप लुकिंग एट द बॉन्ड प्राइस, कीप लुकिंग एट द 3 month ट्रेजरी. एवरीथिंग इज अवेलेबल इन investing.com. ओके, यू कैन सी, यू हैव टू सी द डॉलर इंडेक्स एंड यू हैव टू सी द S&P. सो 4 थिंग्स यू हैव टू सी, अगेन रिपीटिंग, बॉन्ड प्राइस, 10 year. Okay, 3 month treasury, if this keeps going up, so you can predict. So next Fed rate is 21st March. Fed rate happens every 45 days. So after 24th March, the next rate will be approximately in May, 5th May or 4th May. We'll give you the dates. Okay, you can check that in investing.com also. The 3 month treasury. Okay, 3 month treasury shows in advance whether the Fed will increase the rate or not. And then you have to see the dollar index chart. If it keeps becoming weak, that is also a sign. And then the thing most important is you have to see the S&P chart, because S&P is the equity chart which affects the Nifty market. If you see the market fell like this, you see the Nifty chart. Nifty also fell like this. Okay. So again, if this breaks, then we have a big problem. We have a big problem if it breaks 2515. Okay. Anybody has any questions on this, on the exit? I'm giving you a macro view. What may happen in the market? What may happen in the market in 2018? God forbid it does not happen. I don't want to scare anybody, but it's sometimes very important. There is one principle which I've learned. What goes up goes down, and what goes down goes up. So if you have money in March 2019, because the chances of Modi winning the elections in 2019 is very high. So before he starts winning the election, the market might go up from March 2019. But if you have cash, but if you have all the shares are in demat and you have lost all the money, then you will not have cash to invest in that time. And if the market has a tendency to fall not more than 12 to 15 months, that is also a very good sign. Market girta se 12-15 mehna hai, aur fir 8 saal bharta hai. So if you have cash in March 2019, then you put the money in the equity market, you might become a very rich person in 7-8 years and then hold the shares for 7-8 years. That should be the strategy which I recommend. This strategy will only change if Nifty will go up above 11,300 and S&P will go up 2,900. Okay, so what is our strategy? We are in this market also. When we are managing PMS, we bought the market at low and we already booked the profits. Even in this market, we did not lose any money. We can prove it to you. All my clients are there. We can prove it to you that we have not lost any money in this market also. Okay, so it is very, very important. You know, anybody has any questions? Questions? The other. Sorry, just doing the questions. Okay, so I have some question before I take. So your voice is a bit low, can't hear you, good time to short. I don't believe in short, sir. Please, I don't want to give you any training on short or fundamental strategies. We just want to think that if you have shares, you should book profits and you should be careful, you know. That's a good strategy, you know. You definitely, I think so, this year, if you really want to invest, be more in FMCG, IT, pharma. These are good sectors. So IT looks like a good sector to invest in. Definitely, Mr. Aditya. I have another question. Mayuji, as I said, you know, it is not that you should sit on cash. What I said, that try to book profits, again enter when the market gives you a dip, again enter, but exit quickly. It's not a buy and hold strategy. What is the possibility, Surinderji? The possibility, you know, Surinderji, going down 2515 is only when the first result will come, the GDP growth result will come on 30th April. On 30th April, if the GDP is not growing in US, then there will be further fall. So I want to wait till 30th April, whether this 2515 will break or not. So we have to see the bond, we have to see the dollar index, and we have to keep a notice what is happening in the market. Short-term prediction, as I said, Shwetaji, is about, you know, buy on dips and again book profits very quickly. It's not a buy and hold market today. I think so you should book some profits, Mr. Shubhankar. That's my recommendation. That is not possible. These questions are, you know, very difficult to answer, you know, because we can't predict the future. You have to when we see certain triggers and then we decide on our entry and exit, you know. So no, we do not hedge the Nifty PMS. We did not hedge Shrenik. We did not hedge anything with Nifty puts. Okay, Priyanka, if Nifty breaks 2515, it made a low of 2530. If it breaks 2515, then you are in a dangerous state, Priyanka ji. Is a problem. And Nifty below what level? Okay, Nifty also you just show the Nifty chart. I think so. That light, the worrisome in Nifty will be approximately 9600. So if you see this level of Nifty, which is about 9700, so if it breaks 9700, which will be about 1500 points, that is a worrisome factor also. But even if it breaks 10,000, we are in a very dangerous thing in Nifty also. 10,000 and 9700. Okay. You should follow it, but you have to entry and exit, Mayurji. We give you the best shares, but right now the macroeconomics of the world has changed, Mayurji. So you have to know, it's not about following the large cap, it's about the right exit. Yes, it will still affect Mr. Karthik Rao. Anything happens in US, Mr. Karthik, will affect the market in India also. This thing very few people know and very few people talk about it. Okay, so we are giving you an advance notice. So when it happens, you're well prepared. And you'll remember this video for your lifetime that we saved some of your investments. What are the four things to look for? As I said, the four things to look for again, Priyanka ji, is S&P 500. Go to investing.com, see in S&P 500. See the dollar index chart, see the 3-month treasury, and see the US bond price, 10-year. See these charts. Okay, these are the four things to see in US, whether there will be a crash or not. If US will not crash, India will never crash. India has a strong economy. India will not crash. India can only crash if US will crash. Please remember. The world crashes only happens if US crashes. It may happen, you know, if the US will come into an economic problem, Mr. Pradeep, then there will be a problem. Definitely there will be a problem. Praveen ji, yes, beginners, I think so, should stay away from the stock market or invest with fund managers. You know, if you like me, invest with fund managers like us who will protect your funds. Even if we lose, we will try to lose very little money. And when the market will give an opportunity, we'll make money for you. Even all the quality stocks, I have seen all the quality stocks. I'll show you the price. Infosys price. Infosys is a quality stock, right? So do you have a chart of Infosys? Infosys went from 466 from 435 rupees to 66 rupees in 2000. Okay, so all the large cap stocks, all the super large cap stocks fell more than 70-80% in 2000 and 2008. You can go and check. Maybe in the next one of next webinar we'll show you the prices. Stock prices. But actually, I have a copy. Can you just leave? Just, I'll show you the, I'll get you the prices of the top shares. What are the sectors most likely in case the Fed raises? There's no sector there. If right now there is a macroeconomic problem, please understand there is stocks. Above the stocks is the sector. Above the sector is government taxation. Above the government taxation is global problem. So global, then the second part is the government, India government, then the sector, then the stock. So right now we are talking, and there can be a global problem. So if there is a global problem, whether India government or the sector, doesn't matter. Crashes only happen if there is a global problem. Okay. In mutual funds also, it's not a good time because they don't have much exit strategies. So you have to be very careful in investing in mutual funds in 2018. Okay. You need to have a fund manager who know how to exit, keep your money, and then again enter, again exit. That should be the strategy in 2018. All sectors will fall if there is a global problem, Mr. Satya. There is always a relief rally, Mr. Tirumalai. There is always a relief rally, but it does not go to the next high. So if you see the market going to 9,700, market went down to 17,700. Again, it gave a relief rally till 8,700. Again, the market is going down. So there is always relief rally, but it may not go to the next high. So you have to decide to sell your stock 10% below the high. If you're looking for the same high and wait, you may not get the same high again. Any books, you know, these things are all from experience, Mr. Raj Prajapati. You know, so you mentioned gold ETF. Yes, gold ETF, you can invest in an NSE. You can buy the gold ETF through your stockbrokers. Carbon sector will go down a lot because they have really given a big run. So there is a lot of demand. If the market stable, they will be good. So you can, but you have to start booking carbon sector at high, because when the market goes up, they go very high. And when the market goes down, they go very low. So you have to be very careful. Currency market. Yes, we have currency market ka data dala kya. Just bring the currency charts also. You can check on investing.com. Okay, Dukim, where are you from? Are you from India or which country? PNB scam issues, there is a very small issue. We have a bigger problem in US right now. So PNB scam is a very small issue in terms of, but definitely the Indian banks, again, the government will become more stricter and stricter, you know. I don't think so, Mr. Satya, mutual funds are a good option right now. After the LTCG, the long-term capital gain tax, and because they don't exit, they also lose a lot of money. Yeah, Mr. Ramesh Singh, ITs are good, but you have to entry and exit. How quickly should I reckon on exiting, minutes, hours, or days? In days. I don't understand that question. Thank you, Aditya ji, for your compliments. As I said, Anish ji, the Carmen shares are still good. They have a huge demand, but because there is a global macro problem, it might fall. Okay, so keep booking profits. This is my thing. Yes, Rahul ji, if you want to invest with us, we only take minimum 25 lakhs as investment. That is the SEBI mandate. No, we cannot, Rahul ji. We cannot change the SEBI rules. Mr. Riaz Khan, you know, right now the Nifty will only touch 11,000. If the US will go to 28,850, then only US will touch 11,000. So let's see. And you please keep seeing our open interest. February open interest was very bad. So we have to check the March open interest, which will start from 23rd February. 23rd and 26th February, you see our open interest. So if the open interest is plus, Mr. Riaz Khan, so then the market might do something. The Indian bank shares, I don't think so. No, you have been, Mr. Sajjan, 25 lakhs is SEBI mandates. We cannot take less than 25 lakhs. No, I don't. Please do not do any trading in derivatives. Okay. So I do not recommend any trading in derivative Nifty puts. It's a very different market. You need a lot of knowledge. I do not suggest that, Mr. Kiran Nagari. Okay. S&P will break 2500, if S&P will break 2500, then gold prices will go to 1500. So gold is a good option. Mr. Tishikesh Kishan, how about investing in bond? Bond, which bond are you talking about? You can put in some mutual fund debt funds. Another thing is, you have to learn, you can also put funds in mutual fund balance advantage. So we do a lot of investments for our company, for our clients in mutual funds. So right now we are putting most of our funds in balance advantage funds. Balance advantage funds, mutual funds are where the fund manager has that he can move the entire money into debt. So we prefer that. The returns are not more. It is about 14 to 16%. But I think so that is a good investment in mutual fund right now. So if you want, you can come to us and we can invest. So people who don't have 25 lakhs, if they want to invest less money, we can help them to invest in mutual funds, in the right mutual funds. As I said, Karan Agarwalji, you can invest in mutual fund, not in equity, but in balanced advantage funds. Okay. You will not find more balanced advantage fund because they change the names. From 15th March, the names you will get very clearly. 15th March is a deadline where all the mutual funds have to change the name of the, like some, there is a Union Prudence Fund, but actually that is a balanced fund. It is known as a balanced advantage fund, not a balanced fund, a balanced advantage fund. Yeah, it will be uploaded, Mr. Basvaraj. Yeah, right now the Fed rate is about 1.6. If it does, Mr. Karan, if it does not go above 1.75, then the Fed will not increase the rate. And I'm not trying to scare you. I'm trying to give you a precaution so that you are aware that the market also falls. People have the habit, Mr. Karan Ladia, that market always keeps going up. But from history I've seen, the index also falls. So be prepared for it. Mr. SP, we will prefer to invest in balanced advantage fund. Debt funds gives a very low return. I would prefer, again, Mr. Shweta Mishra, you can do SIPs in balanced advantage funds. So if you want help, please mail us. We will help you where to invest in the right mutual funds. Thank you, Kim. You know, as I said, Mr. Leal Belwani, you know, that you can be in the stock, but you need to learn to exit. Number one, and it's better to invest in balanced advantage funds right now. As I said, Mr. Yuvesh Soni, the sectors is not going to work. There is going that there may be a macroeconomic problem. Yes, you can invest, Mr. Aditya, in all our stocks, but learn to exit. I only will suggest quick exits. Quick exits. Yeah, Mr. Diaz can. Sugar sector, again, you know, it might give you a good run because the import duty is considering. So again, but then entry, but again, exit. I am repeating the same thing. I don't like the debt fund because they don't give more returns than 8%. I prefer the balanced advantage funds. No, please do not invest in PC Jewelers, Vakrangi, Gitanjali Gems. Please do not invest. Don't see they are cheap. These companies might go into bigger problems. Never invest in companies which are doing wrong things. Market recovered, did not recover much, only recovered some only. The expected return in gold, Lavanya ji, is about 15-20% a year. You know, so gold also gives a good run. I say, Mr. SB, it is balanced advantage fund, not balanced fund. Do in balanced advantage fund or hybrid conservative funds. Hybrid conservative fund at 75% is debt, 25% equity. Okay, hybrid conservative funds or balanced advantage funds. Yeah, Mr. Ranjan, I feel that there might be a crash like 2008. This is my feeling. If S&P breaks 2515, if it doesn't break 2515, there will be no crash. No idea, Mr. Basu Sharma, about rating companies. Yes, this is right. ICICI Prudential Balanced Advantage Fund is very, very good. Rahul Manchandani, thank you. Everybody can invest in this. So please invest with us so that we also make some money through in the mutual funds. Mr. Junaid Khan, we cannot, we will definitely benchmark our performance through market index. So if the market will fall by 20%, I will lose maybe 5%. If the market will go up by 20%, I'll make more than 30%. 35%. This is my track record. So my performance is related to the index. So individually, if the market will fall by 20%, you might lose 40% of your funds. But if the funds is with me, I might lose only 5%. That is what is our benefit to be with a fund manager. Initially, the fundamental macro problem is the US has decreased the corporate tax, and because the fiscal deficit is going to go big. When the fiscal deficit goes big, there are inflationary pressures. They have to keep increasing the interest rates. So in continuously increasing the interest rates, the markets have a pressure and the markets go down. Okay, so there is a link. So right now, if there is no growth in US in 2-4 months, then there will be a fiscal deficit problem. Trump has increased the fiscal deficit by about $150 billion, $200 billion a year, and that's a huge fiscal deficit. They're already into a 20.5 trillion loan. So if the fiscal deficit will increase, there will be a huge problem in USA. Which bank is good? Vivek, I did not understand your question. Any mutual fund is good for balanced advantage fund. I'm not answering any personal share questions in the seminar. It's more about the market view for 2018. And as you seem very bullish on your outlook, I was bullish, you know, but with the way the markets have shown, now these are indicators. So whenever I've seen in my history, whenever a government increases taxes, after 4-5 days, there is a problem in US. So when I see, then I saw certain problems in China. So that means it is all interlinked. And the way Trump is increasing the import duty, all the countries are getting against Trump because it is affecting global trade. Okay, so there is a global problem which is starting to happen. There are only first indicators. Once the indicators come, the investor should know that we might come into a problem. Right? Precaution is better than cure. Because when the market will go down, you're already out if you're not prepared. Which fund can you repeat? Which fund? I said ICICI Balanced Prudential Balanced Advantage Fund is good. Select Kotak funds. I don't want to recommend on, you know, equity funds right now. Yeah, it got directed, Mr. Harish, the money towards the S&P, but then again there was some problem. But in after the money got diverted in the equity market, the growth is not happening. LTCG impact is not good actually also on the Indian stock market. Whenever I've seen the government tries to you know, take taxes from a growing industry, that industry goes through a setback. So that is another indicator from my experience, because they put a CTT in 2004. The India market is only surviving because of options. The futures of Nifty is very, very low. The world market has grown so much, but the future trading in Nifty has not been growing since 11, 13 years. And the government is not looking into that. 2013, they raised taxes. The commodity market also went through a problem. So with the LTC, with the long-term capital gain tax, there will be pressure in the market. You can invest in SIP, but in balanced mutual fund. And if Modi does not win in 2019, God help us. Gaurav, God help us. As I said, I'm a fan of balanced advantage funds. And by 15th March, there will be a big list of balanced advantage funds. If you want to invest in mutual fund, you can invest through us. The tax cut is not reducing the inflation. In fact, there is a huge inflation right now. No, don't go for 1 to 2 to 5 years, only for 1 year. The market does not fall more than 1.5 years, I've seen. If you see the history, the market goes very quickly. If you see this, you know, the market made a low here, so it was just about 9-10 months. So I think so, if the market has to go down, it does not go down more than 1 year. That is as my story. You should have a lot of cash available with you in March 2019. No, it is not inversely proportional, Mr. Lakshmikant. Dollar index, and they are not inversely proportional. You should just go for 1 year in balanced advantage fund, Vivekji. What to do with running SIP? You know, it's very difficult to answer that question, Mr. Satya. Okay, let's share some data. Now, please start seeing the market from 6 February low. So we made a data, so you should know, from 6 February low, when the market made 7,700, again, metals and mining, IT, infrastructure, fertilizer, because of the government help, and industrial manufacturing are the top 5 sectors. And some of the shares, which has risen from 6th February. Okay. It is Precision Wires, Sunflag Iron, Surya Roshni, Pennar, Tinplate, Jindal Saw, Wellspun, Tata Spawn. These are some of the shares which is risen after 6th Feb. Okay, so I would prefer to please check the shares which are rising from 6th Feb and not see the history, because this, when the market went down, all the companies which is doing wrong things, they will be struggling with the share prices. So I will be following share prices after 6th Feb only. So these are some of the shares which has gone up after 6th Feb. So I recommend some of these shares. In IT sector also, 8K Miles, as I said, is a great share. It has gone up by 38%. So one of the share which I highly recommend is, you know, please show the sector wise slide again. Okay, I'll show you again. This is the sector wise slide. So these are the sectors going from 6th Feb up after the crash. So after the crash, you should see what are the shares going up. So these are some of, you can see these videos again on YouTube. Okay, Du Kim, thank you for your help. Thank you for joining from Hong Kong. So we also do a lot of trading for international customers and foreign institutions. So if you're invested, please contact us. Thank you, Du Kim, for joining from Hong Kong. So these are some of the shares in metal sector. Then you have, these are some of the shares which is risen in the IT sector. So please take note, Compuge, Infinite, Cerebra, Mastec, Datamatics, some of the shares are here. Okay, infrastructure, Solar Infra, J Kumar, Kridin Infra, PowerMac, KNR Constructions. These are some of the shares in infra which is doing well after 6th Feb. Fertilizer sector, Chambal, Gujarat State, National, Excel Corp, Meghbani Organics. These are the five shares I will recommend in fertilizer for you. In industrial manufacturing, Mr. Raman, please give your phone number and we'll contact you. Or please send your email. Please put your phone number here or your email and we'll contact you. And Mr. Basu Sharma, I'm not saying that there will be a crash. There might be a crash. You know, it's not a correction. There might be a crash in the money. No problem. Okay. Okay, so these are some of the sectors in industrial manufacturing. In automobiles, some of the shares which is going up, Lumax, Igrashi. VST Tillers, LG Balakrishnan, Subros, JB Moto. So these are some of the shares which is doing well in automobiles. In the chemical sector, India Glycol, IG, Tirumalai, Sudarshan, Balaji Mines. Some of the shares doing well after 6th Feb. 8K Miles, I prefer 8K Miles Rahulji right now. In carbon sector, it's an all-time favorite, but we have to be very careful, very volatile. If you don't exit, you might lose a lot of money. Philips Carbon, HEG, Goa Carbon, Graphite, Oriental Carbon. In the sugar sector, because there will be an import duty cut, so some of the shares which is risen is Magad Sugar, Rawat Sugar, Dhampur, Triveni, Balrampur, KM. So these are some of the stocks. So if there is an import duty cut, sugar might give you a good run short term. Okay. So we might have our my seminar in Delhi on 7 and 8 March. So if you are interested, we might have a seminar in Delhi, 7 and 8 March. Okay, so if you're interested, you can be there on 7 and 8 March in Delhi. I'll be doing Bombay later, but I'm going to Delhi first. So if you're interested, my seminar date is 7 and 8 March in Delhi. So you can join me in Delhi on 7th and 8th March. 7th and 8th March, 7th and 8th March. It's a two-day program. We'll be sharing a lot of details and a lot of new things and with bad data. We'll also be sharing a lot of data on CentOne. So we'll be giving all the details. 7th, 8th March is the date we've already decided to have the seminar in Delhi. So please join us for the seminar in Delhi on 7th and 8th March. Okay. Mr. Sajjan, I can come to Dubai, but I need at least 10 people because it's going to be very expensive. So if you can get 10%, then I can come to Dubai, Mr. Sajjan. Okay. So we'll give you the place where you're going to have. But 7th, 8th March, we're going to have a seminar in Delhi. So if you want to join us, Anybody, we also do, please contact us in our people who, so this is our app. You can also download our app, D Levels. Please send us an email, support@dynamiclevels.com, or you can give a call in this. Please give your phone numbers and email IDs. We can contact you if you are interested to invest in mutual fund, advantage funds. So we can help you to invest in the right funds. You know, so if you're interested, please give your phone numbers or email. We can take the thing from it. And right now our time is just getting over. Any questions, any last questions anybody has? Did you enjoy the program? Did you enjoy the program? Okay, thank you so much. Anybody wants to give their phone number or email so we can contact you? We can also see your portfolio. We do a free portfolio check. So if you want to send your portfolio, so we can do a portfolio check, please download our app, D Levels, and be cautious in the market. Have an exit strategy. It depends. That depends on the fund manager, Vivekji. He chooses how much he wants to shift in. So balanced advantage funds is a good investment in this year. Anybody else wants to give their phone number or email so we can contact them for PMS investments, mutual fund investments, and thank you for joining in the seminar. You can send us a mail in support@dynamiclevels.com for a free portfolio check. And if your portfolio is above 50 lakhs, I can give you sometime personally, one-to-one. If you have a portfolio more than 50 lakhs, we can share which shares to sell and how to invest. Okay, so our time is over. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you so much. Namaste, happy investing. Be cautious, and thank you so much. If you want to give your phone numbers and emails, please give your phone numbers and emails. And thank you so much. Yeah.